Welcome back to Route 4 TV. Some of our customers have been having some issues with paintballs. Today I want to talk to you about basically magazine-fed paintball and the types of paintballs you can use to get the best results. So here we basically have a few of major manufacturers. We're basically going to be showing sizing the paintballs when it comes to magazine-fed. It's perhaps the most important thing you can do. It's even more important than the thickness of the paint or brittle paint. You can look at that in one direction. We got 685. That's a great ball to use for a magazine fed. The problem is that when you get it to another one, you got 675. So this one right here is actually a very spherical, very round paintball. So this is, and we'll see it shooting as well. This is also a very popular for the field, very popularly used paintball. The problem with this is extremely egg-shaped. So in one sense, we do have what it needs to be. So we're looking at 680. Okay, but the problem is we flip this around and there we go. Without crushing it, we're looking at 649. You'll very likely chop. Why? Because you have the bolt basically, you get part of the lower ball is in the chamber. It's very possible to get a chop with this. Make sure that it's as round as possible, and it does need to be on the higher end. So this one here is 688. This is a great paintball for magazine fed. First we're gonna go with the paints that we know that are sized pretty well, which again, this one right here is giving us great results, as well as the AG1. This is a fully stock MK7P kit. There are some modifications that will give you better results, such as trimming down the ball stopper or the ball detent, and we are working on those too. We can get them out for you guys. This is a complete stock kit, no modifications done to it, including to the ball stopper. This one's not quite as good results as we had with the first magazines, but they were sized properly, so it should give us no problems. We did have a chop in this one. So again, it's very important that the type of paint that we use. This one, again, it's not as uniform as this set of paint, so now we're actually going to be shooting this paint here. This would be the AG1 brand. Now this one right here has been the one that has the most uneven shape and also extremely undersized, so this one right here. Probably get the exact same results with this magazine. In any case, what we've seen for the most part, the most important thing is that the uniform shape and size, as it is in this condition, to shoot the good quality paint once again so we can see the difference, and it makes all the difference in the world. Of course, this right here is something would be you would not want to be using out in the field at this point, but measure the paint, make sure it's round, make sure that the size is definitely not undersized. It does not work well with magazine fed. So thank you very much.